All right, everyone, welcome to this episode of the 80s Glam Livecast. And tonight we're going to be discussing the best and worst metal videos of the 80s. Now here he is, Metal Mike!
All right, thanks CGM. And here we are with another episode, another live stream of the 80s Glam Livecast. Well, we always have a lot of fun on these. It's your comments that make it fun. And tonight's topic's going to be the best and worst metal videos of the 80s. And we'll do a couple from the 90s as well, because you all kind of know, 1990, 1991, the hair bands were still squeezing out a video or two. Oh, hey, we got Greg. What's up, Greg? So here's the question, guys. Where would 80s metal have been without MTV and Headbangers Ball? I think it's safe to say that, you know, metal would never have gotten as big as it was without the support of MTV. It all kind of kicked off in the early 80s, right? That's when metal was kind of getting some videos out there, was getting some commercial backing from the labels, and a couple that come to mind were the first big ones were, Quiet Riot has got to come to mind for everybody, right? I think it's, you know, once again, some of these early 80s ones, they're a little bit cheesy, but man, they were classic, you know? When you think back to Quiet Riot, Bang Your Head, Come On, Feel the Noise, when he's got the mask and he throws the mask and he's in the padded cell, that's pretty classic, man. And then also Twisted Sister, man, with those videos where I want to rock, we're not going to take it. Just classic rebellious videos, and a lot of people copied those, a lot of people. Hey, Ryan saying Kiss has got some killer music videos. Well, you can see from my picture here, Kiss did have a cool video that I really liked in the early 80s, and I hope you guys liked it too, was I Love It Loud. That one was basically, Kiss was made for music videos. We've got the fire, the bombs, and then it's all tied into the house where the fridge is blowing out stuff, and the guy's newspaper's on fire, and ultimately the Kiss army gets into full effect, right? All the kids have the glowing eyes, and they meet up with Kiss. That's just classic, man. Toy Warrior saying I Love It Loud is the best Kiss song. Well, that's debatable, but the video is very cool. And as we'll see as we get going, Kiss has some real crap videos. So I Love It Loud was a good one for them. Now, one band that I think has some pretty poor videos, at least to start the decade off, was Judas Priest. Man, I don't know if you guys checked out the video over for Hot Rockin'. The guys are working out and you know, in the gym, and they're hitting the steam room. Very odd, man. Very cheesy. Headed out on the highway, they're just kind of playing with that painted background with the road. Also pretty chintzy. Breaking the Law, though, is pretty classic. Pretty cool. And another one coming. You got another thing coming. That's pretty cool, too. So they've had a couple okay ones, but some real bad ones, real cheese ones. Most 80s vids were cheese. Me like cheese. Southern Skeptic. I like cheese myself, man. It's funny. It was mentioned that we should talk about cheese in the podcast, but let's keep it the cheesy metal and not like Swiss or any of these other cheeses. I got a bad one for you guys, and I think you'll agree. It's Dokken, Breaking the Chains. There's a part in the beginning where Don's singing the words, and then the girls in the like the background kind of you know, saying what he's saying, and then they're all locked up in the chains. I don't know, man. Pretty damn corny. Grim Reaper, Rock You to Hell. Southern Skeptic saying that one was awful. Yeah, was that the one where there was people in jail cells? I can't really remember. That's what's hard when you try to go back. It's hard to remember all these damn videos. Def Leppard. Photograph, it's okay. You know, it's a good song, and there's got that Marilyn Monroe getting murdered plot, like a subplot. But I tell you which one is horrible from the early 80s is Rock of Ages. That is just odd, man. So odd. And there's the owl and the tree, and it's just super weird. Cook on Mad likes Shandy. Well, Shandy's 1980, so it could be discussed, but not much stands out about the Shandy video to me. Well, it's all good fun, though. Motley Crue. So Crue's got a couple early 80s offerings for us, don't they? Livewire. I mean, Livewire is very cheese video, but I don't know, man. Something about it's pretty cool. You kind of see what Motley Crue's all about at that point. Setting their pants on fire, dumping the blood from the skull in Mick Mars' mouth. So there was some coolness in that video. Really doesn't get much better, though, for them for Looks That Kill. That was basically like taking the inside cover of Shout at the Devil and just bringing it to the screen. So Looks That Kill is cool. Too Young to Fall in Love, though, is not good. That is not good. That's like that Chinatown thing going on. I don't know what the heck's going on with that one. So that's a weird one. And speaking of that one, there's another, and I don't know which one came out first. Actually, it might have been maybe All Hell's Breaking Loose by Kiss came out first. I don't know. But those videos are very similar. There's a lot of bad action scenes in these things. And they're, I don't know, they're walking around in these dingy areas. And I don't know, just odd videos. A lot of odd videos in the early 80s. One cool one and one classic one here is Rat, Round and Round. So very big tune by Rat. And you got Milton Berle in it. You've got Warren crashing through the upstairs, and he lands on the fancy dinner table. And you got the butler that shows off his spiked wristband. That's memorable, man, right? I remember that video. So there's some videos you could say, I can't remember what the heck that video is all about. And then there's other ones that you'll never forget. Oh, Randy Helms, Rock Me Tonight, Billy Squire. That's the video that pretty much ruined Billy Squire's career. He's dancing around like a freak in that one. That's super, super, super bad. You are correct, man. You know what's a weird one? And I had to watch it before the stream because I really couldn't remember it. Is Bon Jovi, Runaway. That one's pretty cheesy. And it's like the girl that's the runaway, is she like possessed or something? She's always got like these flames in her eyes and she sees all these people and then all of a sudden they turn on fire. So is this like, is she like some kind of possessed thing or is this just some weird concept that makes no sense? It could be a little bit of both, right? Here's a cheesy one that I kind of like though. It's Queensryche, Queen of the Reich. You know, once again, a lot of these 80s videos, they try to do the action thing like a sci-fi movie. This one kind of works for me. It's not bad. Not bad. Well, nobody's got more classic videos from the early 80s than Van Halen and with the 1984 album. I mean, Jump, okay, little basic, but it's a classic. Panama, you're seeing them all in their live splendor and Dave's flying around on a string. And then Hot for Teacher, I mean, it's such a crazy video. I mean, it's out of control when they're the little kid versions of them. It's crazy. It's good stuff. Now, here's a question for you guys I got to ask you. Dio. Does Dio have any good videos? Because if I think of the early 80s ones, they're bad, man. Holy Diver's pretty weird. Rainbow in the Dark. Those are some odd videos. So I don't know if anybody's with me on that, but those are bizarre videos. Strange. Wasp. I Want to Be Somebody. It's kind of cool. So they had a couple okay ones in the early 80s. Well, videos really started getting better, right? As the production was getting better, the albums were selling a ton. It was starting to ramp up in the mid 80s. And we're going to touch on those right now. So for me, the band that probably started to really excel with some of the best videos of the 80s is Motley Crue. And if you think back to Theater of Pain, okay, you've got your funny, rebellious video, Smoking in the Boys' Room, very similar to I Wanna Rock, you know, that kind of a style video. But then, man, when you get to Home Sweet Home, Home Sweet Home was basically the template that every hair metal band used for their ballad video, right? Showing the live clips and all the different things that went on during the live show. Almost every other band copied this formula for this video. So Home Sweet Home is definitely a trendsetter. David Lee Roth, he definitely had some pretty cool videos. And for some reason, guys, if you're commenting, I'm not seeing the comments right now. It looks like we're not working on my end, so I apologize if I'm not noticing your comments right at the moment. But David Lee Roth, he had some classics, and it doesn't get much better than Yankee Rose. I mean, what a just representation of what David Lee Roth's all about, man. Steve Vai with all the crazy guitars, Roth with 8 million outfits. It was just funny stuff. Lori, see it. Am I crazy or is the chat moving? Because it's not moving on my end. Oh, there we go. Randy thinks that bands added the live element.
A couple of comments that you didn't see. I don't think you saw them.
So Randy thinks that they added in the live element, like Home Sweet Home. It seemed to be a less, little bit less cheesy. I agree. Because some of the concepts were pretty goofy. Dave is saying Alice Cooper had a few good ones in the 80s. And you know, that's the one where I was kind of questioning, to be honest with you, was Alice Cooper. Because being such a visual guy and with everything that he's got in his arsenal, I kind of think he really didn't put out some of the greatest videos, to be honest with you. Freedom is okay, showcasing his live show. But then when you get to some of the ones off Trash and stuff, you know, that's a whole other subject. I do think Trash is kind of like Alice jumping on the bandwagon. So I don't find his videos very interesting from that era. I don't find his music very interesting from that era. Just my opinion. Lori C. wants to know if Forever counts as the 80s. It will be discussed, but not yet. So don't jump ahead. we're in the mid-80s. That's the late 80s. So we got Randy. What bands do you think videos help them be bigger than they would have been without videos? We're jumping onto something right now that I'm going to touch on that right now, and I think Poison. And hey, we're listening to Poison. Poison aren't the most incredible band to have ever come out, right? They write good songs. None of them are virtuosos on their instruments, but it was the visual aspect of Poison. So I think Poison is a band you can really say that video is what pushed them over the edge. Motley Crue probably as well. Once again, Motley Crue has that it factor. Nobody in the band. Well, Tommy Lee's known as a pretty intense drummer, and Mick Mars, but Vince and Nikki, you know, they're more known for the way they looked in the 80s than the way they sounded, right? Am I right? All right. Let's get back to talking about these videos from the mid-80s. Keel had an interesting one. The Right to Rock. I don't know if you guys remember that one, but basically, it sounds like we're in the future and they're trying to take away rock music. So, it wasn't bad. It's a cool tune. Now, Twisted Sister was back in the mid-80s, and they did Leader of the Pack. And once again, I don't think that video is that great. The band will even tell you that the song was a bad choice for them. So, that one just didn't work. How about Vinnie Vincent? Boy's Gonna Rock. I mean, you could say it's horrible. You could say it's great, right? It's definitely over the top. There's a lot of crap on fire, and, you know, it is what it is. Randy's talking about Britney Fox. Oh, yeah, I've got them listed. We'll get to them in the late 80s section. So let's talk about Poison. So we did say, hey, look, their videos, that's what kind of pushed them over the edge. I know there was a video for Cry Tough. It really didn't do very much. Then we had Talk Dirty to Me, which just blew up. Huge. It's a fun video. I Want Action, kind of very similar, fun. You know, I watched I Won't Forget You the other night, and it's kind of weird. Like, sometimes you'll watch these 80s videos, and you'll just think back, oh, what a fun era. And I think when I listened to that one and I watched that one, I got a little depressed, because sometimes you ever watch these videos and think, man, a lot of time has passed. And sometimes it's depressing. You know, it was 1987, and I was 11 years old. Now I'm 44. So sometimes you watch them, and you, like I said, you the fun aspects there, and sometimes it's like, man, this is depressing. So much time has passed. I don't know if anybody else ever thinks that when they look back at these old 80s videos. Europe, that could be another band that video really pushed over the edge. I mean, Final Countdown was just huge, huge video. And it was a cool video, pretty fun. Dave is saying Dream Warriors, that was pretty amazing. So as bad as some of the Dokken videos are, like Breaking the Chains is bad, In My Dreams is questionable, Dream Warriors is awesome. I think, as you'll see with some of these, when you got the movie tie-in going on, it's kind of fun, you know, right? You can kind of morph between the band and the movie clips. But yeah, that one was just spot on, because they were basically in the same kind of atmosphere as the Nightmare on Elm Street movie. So very cool. How about when Europe does Rock the Night and they're in the Hard Rock Cafe, and they're using the ketchup bottle as the microphone? That's one that could be considered questionable, right? Dave saying Superstitious, favorite Europe video. Yes, very cool. They got the castle and the bombs going off. It's pretty bombastic, right? One that I hadn't seen in a long time and I watched before the stream was Tesla, Modern Day Cowboy. I'm not understanding that one. I'm not understanding that. Some of these just have weird concepts. What the hell is the concept to Modern Day Cowboy? I don't know. It's weird. Def Leppard, obviously, as we got into 87, had some pretty big videos. They're classics, you know, even though Hysteria, some of that stuff gets kind of worn out. They're classics. Same thing with Bon Jovi. I mean, those videos just push the band over the edge. You Give Love a Bad Name, Living on a Prayer. They're just huge, and they're iconic videos. But we got to go for some rare ones. Yngwie had a nice one. You Don't Remember, I'll Never Forget. That was pretty cool. That's a good one. Now, Judas Priest are backed up to their old tricks with some poor videos of this era. Turbo and Locked In are just stupid videos. And there's that little claymation character. It's like the villain of the videos. It's really corny, man. Really cheesy. I think Striper benefited from the video era. I mean, they had some cool videos that really showcased their live setup. I mean, they had the giant Striper logos on the stage. They're throwing the Bibles. It's just bombastic stuff, man. And they had their yellow and black. So, a very visual band. Randy, do you think some of the early 80s bands started writing songs with videos in mind? Yeah, I think so. You know, I think that as the 80s progressed, you knew this was going to be a video. And I honestly think the videos that had the concepts were really the best videos, you know? I mean, there's so many videos that are stereotypical, right? But I think when the video tells the story, like right now, Fallen Angels on, and that one told the story, right? It's about the girl who lives in the small town who comes to the big city looking for fame, and the video follows the story. And there's a lot of them like that, and I think they are the most fun. Lori C. liked Wanted Dead or Alive. Yeah, that's a classic. You know, Wanted Dead or Alive pretty much follows the Home Sweet Home formula, but it works. Like I said, so many people followed that one, and hey, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Kiss. So as Kiss got to the mid to later 80s, they got a little bit more colorful. They looked a little goofy in some of their videos. And I think you could go back and you could probably say that stuff like Tears Are Falling and Who Wants to Be Lonely, they're pretty cheese, man. They're not very distinct. So back when you go back to I Love It Loud, you can say, this is Kiss, man. I'm seeing like the visual interpretation of Kiss. You know, when you get to Tears Are Falling, it's kind of like Kiss trying to be Motley Crue or somebody else. You know what I mean? So, not very original. The Whitesnake videos. You know, Whitesnake big time benefited from the 80s MTV thing. I mean, Whitesnake were kind of dead in the water in the early part of the 80s. And with all those videos, the classic videos they did, I mean, that was monster album. Can't forget GNR. Man, I mean, Welcome to the Jungle is just an iconic video. Crazy. White Lion had some pretty good ones, too. I think When the Children Cry. A lot of times the ballad ones are a little bit cheesier. They kind of all seem the same. But When the Children Cry was pretty cool. A little maybe ahead of its time, you know. It was more of a deeper concept. Oh, here's that sad song. I won't forget you. I'll go get the tissues. Wasp had some decent mid-80s ones. Wild Child, Blind in Texas, pretty decent. Well, this gets us to the late 80s, and the late 80s are when the videos were just going through the roof, man. I think the most money ever was being put into the videos of the late 80s. And probably the band that dominated the late 80s for videos was Motley Crue. I mean, come on. The Dr. Feelgood videos, us out of control, man. You start off with, and the cool thing about Motley Crue with their videos, it's basically always figuring out what their new image is. So they had their metal image in the beginning of the 80s. They had the more flamboyant glam image of Theater of Pain. They had the sleazy image for Girls, Girls, Girls. And let's not forget Wildside. Wildside is cool, man, because you get to see what crew is going to be delivering on their live tour. So that was pretty cool. And then for Dr. Feelgood, the image changed again a little bit. So it was always cool to see what they were going to look like. Dr. Feelgood was cool because it had the concept. You know, they're playing in a fiery tent or something like that. But then they show, like, the drug dealer story going on for Dr. Feelgood. Without You, that's got some pretty cool imagery. Don't Go Away Mad, Kickstart My Heart. So they dominated the 80s with the videos. Lori C, Close My Eyes Forever. Yeah. Ozzy and Lita, very iconic team up. I gotta say, as the 80s came to a close, Kiss's videos got a little bit better. Hide Your Heart is pretty cool. Once again, concept video, tells the story of the song. Then we got to Forever, decent video, did very well. And we've got Rise to It. And Rise to It is when Kiss put the makeup back on. Yes, Dave, Cinderella had some pretty good ones. And you know, Nobody's Fool stands out from the mid-80s. The later 80s, I think their videos got a little bit more classier. And they had a lot more atmospheres out there. You know, like when you think of all that scenery that's in Don't Know What You Got Till It's Gone. And even Coming Home is a pretty cool story video, you know, with kind of some modern flair to it. You know, that was a pretty cool song and video. Well, one video. Oh, A Fish, Poison, Fallen Angel. The song tells the story of the video, and the video follows right along with the song. Yes, Fish, it was just on. We're listening to Poison's Greatest Hits. We just had it on. But we talked about that one. It's a good one. Now, one band that dominated videos was Queensryche. The whole concept of doing the videos for the Operation Mindcrime album was just genius. And, you know, a few of them were in pretty high circulation, but you get to Headbangers Ball, and they were pretty much playing any one of those songs on Headbangers Ball. So that was pretty cool that they had all those videos, and they completely told the story of the concept album, and that's really what sold that album, was the videos, so you could visualize what these characters looked like. So Queensryche just nailed it. Hey Fish, I Thought About You with Badlands. Dreams in the Dark, okay, you know, it's just your traditional live stage video. But Winter's Call is pretty cool, man. There's some cool atmospheres in that one with all the fire. That's a pretty cool video. Vinnie Vincent had some decent ones in the late 80s. Love Kills, once again, you know, we're doing the Freddy Krueger thing, and Vinnie Vincent with the Freddy glove on playing guitar. That's pretty cool, man. That's a good video. Winger, nothing from Wingers really stands out to me. I went back and I watched a few, and I was like, geez, I don't really know if anything's that great. Hungry is kind of cool. That's a concept, and I don't know if you would grasp that concept by listening to the song, but it's a cool cool element. Hey Fish, yes, I was going to get the Cherry Pie. Very stupid video. Janie with the giant smile. It's like super corny. And you know what's funny is when you get to the contrast of Uncle Tom's Cabin, which is such a cool video, such a cool song, you know, it's almost like night and day, you know. Warrant, I think, would have been taken way more seriously if they did not do Cherry Pie and they did not do that video. But what are you going to do? It was a hit. Probably sold a lot of albums, so it is what it is. And Down Boys isn't a bad video. And I kind of like Big Talk. I know Big Talk is like super corny when all the different guys are dressed up as ninjas and swamis and all this stuff. it's pretty fun. Oh, Cook Gone Mad, Up All Night's a good one by Slaughter. Yeah. Kix, Don't Close Your Eyes. If they didn't have that video, I mean, I don't know if we'd even be talking about Kix today. Kix, that put them on the map. I think as you get to the late 80s, you're seeing the best videos by Wasp. The Real Me, super cool video. that goes pretty much along right with the song. So I think those are always the best videos that tell the story that's in the song. Forever Free also, very cool. Lori C says, it doesn't matter if Winger has cheese videos. I love their songs. Yeah. And Lori C probably had the hots for Kip Winger back in the day, so, you know, that never hurt. It was twofold, right? The girls liked to see the guys, and the guys liked to see the girls. That's what sold the videos back in the day. Thinking about movie ones, I always think back to Babylon AD with The Kid Goes Wild for RoboCop 2. You can't beat a video that's got RoboCop in it, man. Come on. And then Terminator in You Could Be Mine by Guns N' Roses. So you got to love when those tie-ins. Inside the Musical Mind. Hey, guys. What's up, brother? How you doing? I got a super cheese video that was in the late 80s for you guys. Nitro, Freight Train. Jim Gillette's hitting those high notes, breaking the glass. A lot of insane looks, giant hair. It was fun, though. Fish, a fish. What is the video where George Lynch is half blonde and half dark hair? I think he did it in a couple videos. I think it's in Breaking the Chains and Into the Fire. I think he had that look for those two albums. Dave, Extreme Decadence Dance. I'm having trouble remembering that one, dude. I remember there was a video, but I can't remember much about it. And Fish, I talked about this one earlier, but Breaking the Chains could be one of the worst videos out there. That's a bad one. That's a cheese ball one. Got to give it to Skid Row, man. Skid Row had actually pretty good videos. Youth Gone Wild is pretty rebellious, pretty cool. And, come on, 18 in Life, that goes right along with the story. You know, Ricky shooting his friend. I mean, that's pretty much tells the story spot on. Yes, Coming Home, Cinderella. Yes, that's a good one. Yngwie's had some hits and some misses. I think Kevin Tonight is a pretty cool video. You know, hey, Yngwie's doing his shredding and the amps are blowing up and all that kind of stuff. That's pretty cool. And those one video, it's very rare. I didn't even know it existed for the song Save Our Love. If you haven't seen that video, go watch that. That's probably one of the cheesiest videos I've ever seen. The guys are all hanging out on a staircase with their fluffy Renaissance shirts. And then there's a certain point Yngwie jumps off the stairs and he turns into an eagle or some shit. It's so bad. It's so bad. Poison. Poison had some pretty quality videos for Flesh and Blood. Ride the Wind, Unskinny Bob. Something to Believe In totally told the story of the song. And once again, maybe a little bit more edgier than some of the goofy stuff that they did, you know, in the mid-80s. So, you know, credit to them. You know, they matured. A Fish, I Remember You. Guy has girl, doing great and happy. Guy loses girl, becomes a homeless street bum. Well, you know, man, all those ballad ones are sad, you know? What about Heartbreak Station, you know? That's a sad one. They're all sad. Ooh, Dave, Blue Murder, Valley of the Kings. Yeah, that's a pretty cool one. With all that, I think it had more of like an Egyptian vibe, didn't it? That was a pretty cool one. Yeah, some of these videos were like almost like movie quality. When I think back to Uncle Tom's Cabin, that was like, that looks like it could have been a movie or a show. You know, it was just so good. Yes, Inside the Musical Mind. I also think that Doc in Heaven Sent is very cool. When they're walking around in the smoky graveyard and all that kind of stuff. Very, very good video. What do you guys think of Burning Like a Flame? That's borderline cheese. That one, they're in some kind of maze. Then they're on fire trucks. For docking, I guess, it's pretty good. So let's talk about Enough's Enough. What do you guys think of their videos? I think that's a band that benefited from video because they're so visual. And honestly, it was a unique visual because they were like glam hippies. Like we'd never seen anything like that. So I think A New Thing and Fly High Michelle are pretty cool videos. Very, very colorful, psychedelic somewhat. Not bad, you know, good stuff. Scorpions. I don't, a lot of the Scorpion videos don't really stand out to me. Obviously, their videos got pretty big, toward the late 80s, or actually early 90s, really. Wind of Change is a pretty cool video. We're seeing the Berlin Wall fall. You know, that's pretty classic. The videos did all really well for Crazy World. THC Groove, Bullet Boys. Yeah, I remember that one. And you remember Talk to Your Daughter? That had Wink Martindale from Tic-Tac-Doe in it. That's a rare fact. I don't know if you guys knew that one. You probably did. A lot of the Bullet Boys videos, though, don't stand out to me. Like, when you think of Smooth Up, it's a big video, but they're just playing, like, in a warehouse. You know what I'm noting? There's a lot of those videos like that. It's just dudes playing in a warehouse. But you know what? You got to see what the band looked like. Did you, like, Talk to Your Daughter? Yeah, that one was... I remember that one. Once again, that was getting tough because it's getting to be the early 90s, and the hair metal thing was kind of phasing out. So some of those hair metal videos just weren't working at that moment. Jackal. Lumberjack with a Chainsaw. How about Great White? None of their videos really stand out to me very much. You know, I know there's that one video, I want to say it's Rock Me. They're just kind of, it's all really dark and you can just see them. And then the girl like turns into a mermaid or a fish lady or something like that. And then Once Bitten, Twice Shy is, once again, it's just kind of like the guys in a warehouse, right? Practicing. I don't know. And then their girlfriends are singing the backups. I don't know. It's okay. You know, it worked. There's a lot of those rehearsal type videos or bands in like apocalyptic situations, like Tesla. Seems like the videos for that album, like Hang Tough, Heaven's Trail, it's kind of the vibe that I'm getting from those. House of Broken Love was a good one by Dave. Oh, LA Guns. Yeah, I haven't mentioned LA Guns at all. And LA Guns have some pretty cool ones. And I'll tell you a funny story. I interviewed Kevin Steele from Rocks Gang, and he had talked about their song Red Rose. And they were going to make a video for that. And the video idea was like a white mansion with all these rose petals all over. But the video never got made. And ultimately, the director that was going to do it stole the idea and gave it to LA Guns for the Ballad of Jane. So it's pretty funny, you know, that happened that way. But yeah, you know what? Speaking of LA Guns, Never Enough is a cool video. You know, because that one is basically like the Ed Sullivan throwback, the 60s. And that's pretty clever. I like that one. That's very good. Whitesnake, kind of pulled in the late 80s, they were kind of rehashing what they did in that 87 album. But once again, you got Steve Vai playing all his crazy guitars. I think Now You're Gone is more just a performance video. So, you know, I love that album. Well, Slip of the Tongue is a jammer. How about the video that Steve Vai did? The audience is listening. That's a cool video. Not a hair band, but We Die Young in 1990 was a great video, Charles. We Die Young. I'm like having a brain fart. Is We Die Young? I'm thinking of Warrior Soul, We Cry Out. We Die Young is Alice in Chains. Okay, had a little brain fart on that one. But yeah. Alice in Chains videos are actually pretty cool. Yep. But remember, there were videos by Warrior Soul that were pretty cool. Warrior Soul is one of those misunderstood bands, you know what I mean? It was just like, they weren't metal, they weren't alternative, they just were their own thing. And I guess at that point, you needed to be labeled something. Switchblade Serenade, Spread Eagle, yep. Losers, yeah. Great song, great. Yeah, Spread Eagle had some pretty cool ones. Now, Judas Priest finally got some decent videos when we got to like 1990. Painkiller was cool. Touch of Evil was cool. So it's nice to see that Priest actually pulled off some pretty cool videos after a bunch of shitty videos that they had in the early 80s and the mid 80s. And I want to say the only video for Ram It Down was Johnny B. Goode. And Johnny B. Good's a little divisive. Not a lot of people like Johnny B. Good. I can't believe they didn't have a video for Ram It Down. That's kind of bizarre. It's funny. I Want Action's On. And I honestly could not remember that video. And that video is kind of like goofy. I had to go back and watch it. Like the waitress comes over and doesn't know who they are. And it's more of like a spoof type of a video. Ugly Kid Joe, Neighbor. Yeah. Ugly Kid Joe definitely had some cool ones. What was I Hate Everything About You? That was their big one. Yeah, you ever notice how the visual quality of videos was changing as you got to like 1990? And the quality of video that became very normal is like Queensryche Empire, if you think of that video. And some of the Metallica ones look the same way. I don't know if the same dude was making all these videos or if everybody was copying each other. That's pretty much what it came down to, you know what I mean? Probably any director could have made these videos. They all kind of look the same. Queensryche, I Don't Believe in Love, and Eyes of a Stranger. Once again, very cool videos. Tell the story of the Operation Mindcrime album. Very, very good stuff. And they had a string of great videos on the Empire album, so yeah. Quiet Riot, Charles. Party All Night. They're at a house party. Very cheesy. Twilight Hotel is some kid has got him in some kind of a box or something, right? And they're in some kind of weird dream world. Or are they in a dollhouse? Weird, very weird concept. And what's even the weirdest is that if we look at Kevin DeBro's hair from 1984 to 1986, I mean, that's the most bizarre because he just had a whole set of hair from out of nowhere. But I actually like the Wild and the Young. It's probably because I like the song so much. The video is okay. Once again, it's like that futuristic scene. It's not bad. I think we talked a little bit about the Europe videos as we got to the late 80s. Superstitious, Open Your Heart, Let the Good Times Rock. Yeah, his hair looked amazing. Kiss Unholy was a complete change from their 80s videos. Yes. One thing you can say, well, there's a lot you can say about Kiss Revenge. One of their better albums, of course, and some of their better videos. I mean, Unholy is probably their best video. I mean, when you look at all that crazy stuff that was going on with all those, you know, demented scenes, they're in the black and white, and it looks heavy, you know what I mean? It's a cool video. Wait a minute, I forgot one of the best videos. It might have been 1990, but Megadeth, Hangar 18. I mean, come on. That's like a sci-fi movie. It's amazing. It's so good. So there were some cool, cool videos as we got to the end, you know, of the 80s and the early 90s. Charles, are there any songs that didn't get a video, but their lyrics were too good not to have a video? There's probably some. There's probably some. Let me throw this one at you guys. Now that there's YouTube, you ever going through YouTube and you're looking up certain bands and you see a video that they had out that was made back in the day, but you never saw? And I find this is very common when you get to like 1991 or in that era, 92. Like Bitter Pill off Dog Eat Dog. I remember seeing Machine Gun off Dog Eat Dog by Warrant, but I never saw Bitter Pill because at that point, MTV wasn't playing their videos. Same thing with Poison. I saw Stand, but that was the only video I saw. I never knew they had a video for Until You Suffer Some, Fire and Ice. And if you probably had to stay up to the wee morning, hours of the mornings, if you ever wanted to see Winger Down Incognito, but there was a video for that. But once again, it wasn't getting played too much. Kevin and Dave, so glad you guys are mentioning Sabotage, because I think Sabotage had some killer videos. Haul the Mountain King is a killer video. And the ones for Gutter Ballet are incredible. Very visual, and they go perfectly with the song. Bitter Pill by Warrant was made on a small budget. But back to Gutter Ballet and When the Crowds Are Gone, those are very cool videos. So, yeah, Sabotage had some good ones. Lori Loves Down Incognito, I know that. You know what's a shame? Charles, you were talking about songs that should have gotten a video. Now, I don't know if this ever really should, I mean, I don't know if we can constitute what should or shouldn't have got a video, but when you think of Cinderella, Still Climbing, it's a good album, man, but it was 1994, and there was no videos ever put out for that album, not that I ever seen, and I kind of scoured the internet looking for them, nothing. That album just came out with a whimper. I think that it was contract, you know, it was a contract thing that they just had to put it out there, so it's unfortunate, you know, because the album sounds good, and there's good songs, but no videos. And, you know, there's a few other ones that I stumbled upon out of nowhere, and I was just like, damn, I did not know this had a video. How about You're All I Need by Motley Crue? So they said that that video was too violent or too something. It was about the guy killed his girlfriend so he could be famous or some crap. And when you watch it, it's like, are you serious? This is offensive? Come on. But there was a few that got banned for goofy reasons. Twisted Sister, Be Cruel to Your School was banned as well for being too gory. There was a lot of zombies and stuff like that. And that video is awesome because it had Dee and Alice, man. And it was really, the special effects are pretty much on par, the makeup with Thriller, I think. Rat Black says, Cinderella, yes. A Fish, White Zombies videos were way out there. Yeah, I'm trying to remember Thunder Kiss. That was a pretty wacky video. Charles, Bon Jovi can make a cool video. And I say this as someone who can't stand them. I'm on the fence, man. There's some Jovi stuff that I like, and there's some Jovi stuff that I don't like. And I don't really like New Jersey, and I don't like really any of those videos. And I think some of those videos are super lame, especially Born to Be My Baby, where they're just in the studio. Come on, the video sucks. Lay Your Hands on Me is pretty good because that's like the big live show. I can deal with that video. Hey, Lori C just said Lay Your Hands on Me. So Lori C and I are thinking sync quite a bit. Could be, you know, for being together since 1994, that might be some of the reason why we think alike, but there's some things that Lori C thinks that I'll never think alike with her on. and her, me. Yeah, but yeah, those are some pretty decent videos, some of those Jovi ones, the live ones. Those are the cool ones. Yeah, A Fish, Wanted. Yeah, and I've talked about this earlier, that Wanted Dead or Alive is a classic, and I want to see if you agree with me, but I think Motley Crue created that template. You know, Home Sweet Home was, I mean, Poison made a couple Home Sweet Homes, you know what I mean? So, Kevin saying Wild Side, Hang On Lucy. I can't remember that one, my friend. Striper. Yeah, Striper had some cool videos. And what's cool about Striper is that it was nice when they did Against the Law because you got to see them in their new look, you know? And what do you think that really, at the end of the day, the videos also served as like, what's the new look for the band? What's the new stage show going to look like? So the video served a kind of as a preview of what you were going to see live. And also, I think the videos created the fashion that a lot of us followed, right? And our hairstyles. I remember when Motley Crue did Don't Go Away Mad, and Nikki and Tommy had the sides of their head shaved. Me and my friends all did that. We all had long hair at the time, and we all shaved our sides because they did. It was just like, that was the style. That's how you knew what the style was, you know? And it's really no different than stuff like when Madonna and Prince were out, you know what I mean? The girls tried to look like Madonna. But people wanted to look like Nirvana. Not us 80s metal guys, but there were people that wanted to copy Nirvana. It's just, it set the trend, man. Those were the trends and those were the fashion styles. Charles, did I say Shining Love by Odin? No, but that's a cheesy ass video. I know what you're talking about. That's super cheesy. Jet Boy, speaking of hair. Oh my. That spike mohawk is out of control. Handy Rocks. Yeah. They never really put much out in the later 80s. Obviously, it was Michael Monroe. You guys hear Flesh and Blood right now? I remember this song being, or video being pretty cheesy. And also the video for So Tell Me Why off the live album. It was like the only footage that they recorded was of Brett. They kind of phoned it in on a couple of those Flesh and Blood and the live album videos. You know what was a cool one that was toward the end of it all was Extreme, Three Sides to Every Story. Why Am I Losing It? Whatever their big song was off that one. That was a good one. Nelson. You know, after the rain, I was never big into Nelson. They were a little light for my taste. But After the Rain was cool, man. And that was one of those, it's like the kid goes into the dream and he's at the concert. But they were like playing on all these rocks and all this stuff. And some of those like fantasy stages were just so cool. You know what I mean? Like, it was just awesome. Any Wasp videos I like? Yes, Charles. I think the videos from the Headless Children were the best Wasp videos. They pretty much told the stories very well. Some of the other Wasp videos, they're not bad. They're just kind of a little bit of cheese. Ozzy. Yeah, we didn't mention Ozzy. And the best Ozzy video of all time, A-Fish, is Bark at the Moon, man. I don't care what anybody says. When Ozzy's the wolf man, come on. Crazy Babies is kind of creepy. Shot in the Dark's pretty classic. You got your glam metal Ozzy. What about Ultimate Sin when Ozzy's like JR? That's pretty weird. No More Tears is a good video. That was using those modern techniques with videos at that point. So, yeah, man, a lot of cool stuff. Lori C, Vixen. Yeah, I guess. I don't know. Vixen, I just remember Vixen being on the stages. I don't remember them ever having a concept video of any kind, but whatever. Headless Cross from Sabbath. Dave, I don't remember that one. I just remember thinking Tony Martin was like not that cool looking, or he didn't have good hair. Isn't that sad how many times we judge people by their hair? Maybe it's just me. Maybe I was just one of those posers that like judge people by the way their hair look. But sometimes if the guy had, like a guy in a band had short hair, I'd be like, what the heck? Go back and watch I'll See the Light Tonight by Yngwie Malmsteen. So Jeff Scott Soto must be out of the band. And I want to say that's Mark Bowles, but he's got wicked short hair. And, like, he just doesn't fit in the band. You ever notice, like, the guy that has short hair in the band? He looks like an oddball. It was like that with Night Ranger. It was like you had two guys that had short hair, and then you had all the other guys that had long hair. And it was, like, just looked weird to me. You know what I mean? So anytime that would happen in a video, I'd be like, what up with the short-haired guy, you know? And now I barely have any hair, so I guess I'm getting payback for those kind of critiquing people for their hair. Cry Tough's on. That had a video. That was their first video that really didn't do anything. And I can't really remember the video, so I don't know. I think it's just a performance video. Tracy said the guys were so pretty back then. Okay, Tracy, we're going to have to assume that you are a girl because you're saying the guys were pretty. Charles, George Lynch had short hair. Yeah, his hair sucked. Him and Don had kind of shitty hair, man, in the early 80s. But then when they got to 88, 87, then they look cool. Fiona, or Lori's talking about Fiona, Everything You Do, You're Sexing Me. With Kip. That's pretty classic. It's kind of like the Lita, Ozzy thing, but not as good, of course. Here's another one, Rat. To me, correct me if I'm wrong, but it seemed as though the Rat videos started to get worse as their career went on. I watched a little bit of like Shame, Shame, Shame and stuff like that. Those videos sucked. I mean, I just remember like Rat having the videos, man, back in the day when they started. But the video that they do, Nobody Rides for Free, where they're out on the beach and it's for Point Break, that's a pretty cool video. Yes, Lori C., I thought we already talked about Hide Your Heart. Hide Your Heart is a cool video. And I gotta admit, the acting and all that kind of stuff is pretty cool, man. It's decent. It gives that vibe of the video. And then when Gene Simmons closes the ambulance in the end, come on, man. That's classic. A Fish, The Last Time. Yeah, shit blowing around. Oh, A Fish, I got one for you where all the shit's blowing around and it's really out of control. Is Do You Like It by Kingdom Come. That's insane. The big giant speaker is blowing everything all over. Kevin, Much Music out of Canada. I could get it on my satellite. They played metal videos until 96. They made a big deal of Motley Crue Hooligans Holiday. Yeah. Hooligans Holiday is a weird video. It definitely doesn't feel like the Dr. Feelgood era anymore, does it? Oh, no. And Kevin, you had to mention Motley 94. A Fish is bouncing around the house because you mentioned Karabi and Motley 94. You know what's a cool video? Misunderstood's a pretty cool video. I'll give him that. Lori C, Fire Woman. Yeah. Yeah, man. Because the Cult basically doing the hair metal thing, you know? Fitting in with that scene. And those are pretty cool videos. Charles, Pro Shot Metallica videos from their concerts. Not much for a music video, but they looked amazing. Yeah. Well, let's talk about Metallica, because Metallica was really holding off on the videos, right? They didn't do any videos until One. One is kind of a dismal video, right? And it's a long video. But, you know, it's cool. It fits the song. And, yeah, I mean, Enter Sandman and all that stuff. I mean, that was their era for videos and having big hits. Tracy, what are my thoughts on the Electric Angels? I remember them, but I can't really tell you any other songs. So I'm sorry. Lori C, When It's Love. Lori C, I'm not going to talk about Van Hagar. Sorry. Christina Applegate was in the Electric Angels video. I don't remember that. I don't know. I remember Shotgun Messiah had a few videos. There was just so many videos. Pretty Boy Floyd had Rock and Roll's Gonna Set the Night on Fire, and they had I Wanna Be With You. Ryan Roxy was in Electric Angels. Yes. Yep. Your Mama Don't Dance. This was your typical live video. It seems like Poison went to this well quite a few times, didn't they? I'm trying to think some more classics here to talk about. There's so many. Someone Like You, Brittany Fox, yeah, Bang Tango. Those were cool videos. I just remember the neon colors. Very colorful videos. And obviously helped their career big time. Slaughter had a lot of videos. But I don't remember. I can't think of one over the other one. The one that probably stands out the most is Fly to the Angels, where they're in the airplane hangar. That one's a pretty cool video. Warrant, we talked about them a little bit. A big thing that Warrant did, and a lot of other bands did, is they started doing the, like, it's a black and white video, but it has some color. And I think that's what they did for I Saw Red. And you see a lot of weird colors in some of these videos. A lot of weird shots being done. Dave's trying to remember the Steelheart video. Yeah, I can't really remember it either. I just know it was big. Just probably file it under a band in a hangar or in a warehouse. Cinderella had the twins. Yeah, like the evil stepsisters. Yeah. Blaze of Glory. Lori C. Yeah. That was a pretty cool one. I mean, it's Bon Jovi solo. He's all on his own. He's up in the mountains.
doing his little acoustic guitar thing. And there's all those clips from the Young Guns movie, so it's pretty cool. Back to Europe. I'm trying to think of some of theirs. Cherokee was a pretty cool one. That's where they're out in the desert. Carrie, it's just your typical. That's your typical ballad one. So much of the ballad ones are just not memorable, or they're not exciting. They're just the same crap. Kevin Rose, Steelheart, Sticky Side Up. I don't remember that one. Another one that I was having trouble remembering videos by were Firehouse. I just think some of the videos were getting so generic, you just can't remember them. I had to go watch Don't Treat Me Bad. I didn't remember what the hell was going on. All She Wrote's a live, your typical live video. Oh, you know who benefited from the videos was Trickster. They had a pretty interesting look. They were like the, you know, they were doing the flannel thing before grunge came in. And once again, it looks like they were playing in their cellar. It was a file that one under band practice. Trickster's at band practice. Lori C, Tesla Love Song. Yeah, Tesla Love Song, you got to file that under the performance clips, you know? So, like, some of it's being filmed on the stage that's not live, and then we intermix the live clips. Yeah. Alice in Chains, A-Fish, The Rooster. Yeah, that's a good one. Oh, one of my favorite bands I didn't mention who really only had one video in the 80s was Manowar. I don't know if anybody ever seen Blow Your Speakers. That's pretty funny. The kids ransack the electronics store. They want them. They want some Manowar. The Manowar music's blowing up the speakers. And then, of course, Manowar is doing all their shtick live. And A-Fish, I know you love Manowar, so I'm glad I'm talking about this. You know, Manowar's railing their guitars against each other, and they're doing the muscles, you know, showing off their muscles, their chaps. It's classic. Charles, Badlands had videos. Yes. We did talk about those, but we'll catch you up to speed with them. It was Dreams in the Dark, Winter's Call, and The Last Time. Bo Nasty, Dave. Yes, I just interviewed, you're right, I just interviewed Brian Young. Shake It. You ever notice, I almost wonder if Fish, you in 1994 Motley Crue is like me with Manowar. Yes, you are correct. Tracy, you saw Manowar at Lemoore's. Nice. I saw Manowar at the Lost Horizons in Syracuse. So, yeah, good stuff. Now, okay, the thought that I just had was when you go back to, like, somebody like Bo Nasty, you ever notice that they gave him, like, I feel like some bands got, like, that one shot. They gave him one video. If that video tanked, they were done. They got no more videos. And then if that video did good, then you got another one. So here's another interesting thought. This happened with a couple bands. Think about the Great Radio Controversy album by Tesla. Heaven's Trail did nothing. Hang Tough did nothing. Then Love Song came out and it was a hit, and that pretty much carried the album. And it's the same thing that happened with Kix. Kix did, oh God, they had what? Cold Blood, Get It While It's Hot, all that stuff did nothing. Then all of a sudden, Don't Close Your Eyes comes out and it's huge. So it's just weird how the way that goes, you know what I mean? It's funny. Those ballads really carried the albums. And we could probably say that about other ones. But those are two that really stand out, that the albums were going nowhere. And then all of a sudden, a hit. Kind of happened with Kiss for Hot in the Shade. The legend is that Hide Your Heart wasn't doing much. And they pretty much didn't think, the label had no hope for Hot in the Shade. And the tour pretty much got sidelined. It wasn't going to happen. And then when Forever got big, it was basically like the thing really picked up some steam, And that's when they were able to do the tour. And, of course, they brought some big bands out with them. They brought Winger. They brought Slaughter. Some shows had Faster Pussycat. So, you know, that helped the tour. Hey, Fish, so many bands followed the same formula. Yes, you had to do a heavy song first. Then you could do your ballad. Then you could do your mid-tempo. Yeah, it was kind of the way that it worked. Read My Body should have gotten a video, Charles. Yes, you're right. And by all accounts, it was going to get one. I remember I got some kind of Polygram record sampler. You know, like at the record stores. I'm not talking about drugs. I'm talking about like they give you a promo, and then when that would happen, you'd see what songs were going to be singles. So I remember there was like Hot and Bothered by Cinderella and all these different songs. And Read My Body was on this with all these other songs that were released. So, yeah, I don't know what the heck happened with that. But I can't remember. I think one time we were having a Twitter discussion and it came up that somebody said, hey, Read My Body is just a wannabe of Pour Some Sugar on Me. And for years, I never noticed it. And it really is a wannabe of Pour Some Sugar on Me. Blow My Fuse, Adriana. Yeah, that was a video too. They really didn't do anything. But it was that ballad, man. Don't Close Your Eyes that really propelled that album. Something to Believe In. Big video. Big song for Poison. And look at the ballads, they carried the albums. Look at Warren's first album, Heaven and Sometimes She Cries. So a lot of times there might have been kind of like two ballads that would carry the album. So that's the way it went. Well, guys, we've done an hour. We went a little bit over an hour. Let me just get you up to speed real quick on a couple things that I'm working on. This weekend, I'll put out an interview with Rowan Robertson from Dio. So we kind of got some insight from him about what it was like being a 18-year-old kid in Dio. I did an interview with Donnie V. Somebody else mentioned this that was in the chat that they did one as well. I think I got some pretty cool insight from him. He pretty much tells it like it is. So he's got a love-hate relationship with Chips Enough. And he just kind of talked about how they got caught in the crossfire about the hair metal thing. And I got a special Whitesnake episode coming up where I interviewed Joel Hoekstra. And if you get a chance, check out his album, man. His new album, Running Games, super good. And I did a podcast. I was on somebody else's podcast, On the Fly, and we talked all about The Elder. We go through all the songs that we like, the songs that we can't stand, and we discuss my my vision for an Elder movie that I put out on my YouTube channel. So if you get a chance, check that out. And once again, thanks for joining the live cast. It's always a pleasure talking to you guys. So glad you brought up videos that you remembered, because some of them I didn't. And some of them I'll go back and try to refresh my memories. But hey, man, it's been a long time, right? Some of this stuff is over 30 years ago. It's hard to remember all this stuff. So, hey, have a good night, guys. We'll do it again next week. Take care.